What's up, Navigation Traders? Today is Friday, August 3rd. Hope everybody had a great week of trading. Welcome to this week's video update. Before I jump in, just want to make note, you've probably been receiving some emails. We are increasing the price of our pro membership. Brought on a bunch of several new people. We're going to be accelerating the stuff that we bring out to you guys. So got some really exciting stuff. If you are a monthly subscriber and you wanna jump into the annual membership at $4.99 a year, do that before Saturday, August 4th, so tomorrow, because then the price is going up from $4.99 to $9.97. But anyone who locks in before tomorrow will be grandfathered in for the life of your membership. So definitely do that if you're interested. Just if you're a monthly member, just email support@navigationtrading.com and they'll take care of you. And then if you're already a annual member, you are locked in for life. So there's a little bit of confusion. Probably wasn't as clear as we needed to be in the emails, but you are locked in at whatever you're doing. So if you're doing the monthly, you're locked in the monthly for life. If you're doing the annual, you're locked in the annual price for life, so no action is needed from that standpoint. So let's jump. Oh, actually, one more thing I wanted to mention. We've also updated our blog. So if you go to our blog, just click on blog here at the top menu of the site. Hopefully this is a little bit more user-friendly. We've got some different topics, so you can kind of go just to the monthly performance blog post, some of the different trading options for income strategies, directional strategies, backtesting studies and posts that we've done, Tastyworks videos, and then just other topics of video blogs. So we've categorized those, and then of course they're all in order from the newest post first. And so hope you enjoy that. Let us know if you have any feedback on that or any suggestions or topics that you want us to cover. We'll be continuing to add stuff to our blog here in the coming months as well. So exciting stuff here, and super excited about a couple things we have coming for you. I can't mention it yet, but it's coming soon, so stay tuned. Let's jump into the alerts for the week, starting with Monday. First trade was a closing adjusting trade in wheat. So that we closed out the put vertical side as price breached our upside break even. And so let's take a look at where we're at here. So here is that remaining call side. Price has been really strong in wheat. Wheat has been my nemesis for the last year, basically. Every time I think we're about to close it out for a profit, we end up having to extend duration and make some adjustments. But it's kind of cool. Once this is closed out, it'll be a good example of a trade. I'll do kind of a recap of the entire trade going all the way back to last year. And, this is part of the game. Not every trade is going to be a winner right off the bat. And knowing how to manage those trades and make the necessary adjustments is critical to being consistent. So anyway, here is the short call vertical. You can see price is way out here. Need some downside movement. Still got a decent amount of time here, 21 days to expiration before we need to do anything there. And then we've also got this other full iron condor, which is out in October. You can see we're making some profit there, not enough to take off yet. So we're just playing the waiting game in wheat at this point. Next trade was a closing adjusting trade in QQQ. So we closed out one of our sets of short call verticals. That's previously part of an iron condor. Booked a profit on that piece of the trade. And so we ended up just closing it out, booking that profit on that piece because we're still holding our other two sets of short call verticals. We were starting to get a little bit too short biased in our portfolio overall. So it just made sense to take off some of that short delta. So we just closed that out. If we take a look at the queue, actually, I'm gonna go back to the queues here because we've got another alert on the queue. So I'll go back to the platform once we hit that one. Next trade was an opening trade in EEM. IV percentile at the time jumped up to 55, so we sold some premium, sold a strangle in EEM. That trade is still fairly centered. Got a little bit of profit here, as you can see, but not enough to take off yet. So just waiting for some more theta to decay in EEM. Next trade was an opening adjusting trade in IWM. So what we did is we simply added an iron condor in September, IV percentiles at 69 at that time. And then we also hold our other piece of that trade, which is, so here's the iron condor. You can see we've got a little bit of profit there, but not enough to take off yet. And then we've got this other piece, which is a short call vertical from our other iron condor. Just continuing to look for a little bit of downside to benefit that piece. We're right at about break even, maybe down a little bit on our IWM trade overall. Assuming price stays relatively stable, should be out of this here in a couple weeks for a profit, but we will see what happens. Obviously, if we need to make additional adjustments, we will. Next trade was an opening trade in Goldman Sachs. So we haven't done many calendars for a while because implied volatility hasn't been low enough to warrant doing it. But IV percentile on Goldman Sachs at this time was right at 3, so super low. We like that IV percentile, IV rank to be under 10 is when we really like to start putting these calendars on. So going to look for about 20 to 25% profit. We've got about 10% profit at this point. You can see it's still nice and centered, about 8%, almost 9% profit at this point. But you can see, we'll just let some more time to pass. If we look at the chart, you can see implied volatility is super low in Goldman Sachs, next to zero here. So if we get a little bit of a pop in implied volatility and prices stay relatively stable within our range, we'll be able to book this profit. On calendars, if it does go outside of our range, we'll most likely add another calendar and turn that into a double calendar and continue to manage that. So nothing to do here yet in Goldman Sachs except for wait. Next trade was an opening trade in Disney. So we did a pre-earnings long straddle in Disney, looking for some price movement and expansion of implied volatility going into earnings. They announce on 8/7, so we want to be out of the trade by then. So if we take a look at Disney, we've gotten, let's take a look at the chart. So in implied volatility, we did have one pop yesterday up in implied volatility, which helped offset some of that theta decay, which is why we are pretty much break even right now, down just slightly. But we need some price movement to really benefit this thing, either up or a big move down. We're going into earnings on 8/7, so we'll be taking this off early next week. So hopefully we can get a little bit of a price movement before then to book a little bit of profit. Next trade was an opening trade in Google. So we did a short put vertical in Google, and we did this for a couple of reasons. One, we're anticipating a little bit of an up move in Google, obviously, and then second, again, we are starting to get a little too short in our overall portfolio, so adding in this bullish trade, some long delta, helps balance that out. If we take a look at our Google trade right now, it's down about 0.75% today, but we're still in the profit a little bit, up about $120, looking for a little bit of up movement to benefit that trade. And from the charts, here's kind of what I was looking at. So after earnings, it jumped up pretty significantly, not quite enough to warrant putting on a post-earnings short put vertical. However, it would have worked had you done that, because we did get a couple days of up movement, but it pulled back down to this level here and just look. So for any time you get a decent up move and then a little bit of a pullback on that first move, I like to that tends to be a good point of entry. I'm not saying it's a super high probability, not looking at any specific technical analysis indicators or anything like that. We're just simply A, adding some long delta in our portfolio, and B, this looked like a good entry for a little bit of a bounce higher. I mean, if we get up to 1260 or 1270, which would be pretty easy to do, pretty realistic, we're looking at booking 40, 50% of max profit on that trade. So that's kind of what we're looking for here on Google. Next trade was a closing trade in Facebook. So last week we put on a post-earnings short strangle in Facebook, and we were able to take it off just a few days later, 5 days later to be exact. Booked over 30% of max profit, so nice trade in Facebook. And if you remember what happened in Facebook, let's just kind of go back. Let's go back to that chart to recap. FB. So what we're looking at is, you know, after earnings, the stock was down about 20%. So huge move down. And what happened is after, because it moved down so much, we did not get that implied volatility crush right after earnings that we typically do. So we sold some premium with those price option prices that IV still elevated. And then the very next day, we got that little bit of a collapse. And it popped up and then continued to decline. So it worked out nicely. Price kind of stabilized around that level. And we were able to book a nice quick winner. So good trade there. Next trade was an opening trade in NVIDIA. So we did a pre-earnings long straddle in NVIDIA. Again, kind of like Disney, looking for some IV expansion and price movement leading up to earnings. They don't announce until 8:16, so we still got some time in this trade. If we take a look at NVIDIA, we have not gotten any expansion in implied volatility. It's continued to decline, so if we can see a little bit of a pop-up and then a little bit of price movement, should be able to book a winner. But you can see we're still basically at break-even here, no profit or loss at this point. So we'll see what happens next week in NVIDIA. Next trade was a rolling adjusting trade in Apple. So we went ahead and held this trade through earnings. Unfortunately, Apple did make a move higher. So let's go to the chart here. You can see price is out of our range. So looking for some downside to benefit this trade. You can see Apple's just been, you know, really strong. So we're looking for a little bit of a turnaround to benefit that piece. And again, the whole reason we put that trade on to begin with was to add some short delta in our portfolio. So we still need that short delta, so we'll continue to hold that for now. Next trade was a closing adjusting trade in FXI. So we closed out one of our butterflies, booked almost 50% profit on that piece of the trade, and then we're still holding our other September butterfly. So if we take a look at FXI here, what you will see is this trade is still fairly centered, hanging out a little bit towards the upside range, but still just fine. And then our other butterfly here. And remember, one of the reasons we use puts and calls is to help separate them. So right now we're clicked on just the call butterfly, so you can kind of see what that is here, and then to keep them separate to make it easier for tracking, we did the other one in puts, which is the one I just showed. So just waiting for some more time to pass, more theta to decay. This one could use a little bit of upside movement, and the other one could use a slightly downside movement. So if we click on all these, what you'll see is this basically mirrors, kind of looks like an iron condor, right? You've got this span here where we can profit. We've got our defined risk. So it's just two butterflies combined, almost looks like an iron condor from the risk profile. So just overall with both of them together, you can see we're very centered. So just waiting for some time to pass before we do anything here. Next trade was an opening trade in Tesla. And what we did here is we did a post-earnings short put vertical in Tesla. So just like we teach in our earnings course, if price moves up beyond the expected move, and so for those of you who are newer and may not understand what the expected move is, let's go to Tesla. So if you go to your trade tab, you can look at this a couple different ways. You can look on the very far right-hand column, and what you'll see is, depending on which cycle you're looking at, the in parentheses, it shows the plus or minus the expected move. So that's basically plus or minus a one standard deviation move. So you can see with just today, there's an expected move of about $4, plus or minus either way. If you go out to August, for example, there's an expected move of around $28. So right before earnings, let's go to the chart here. I actually marked it. There it is. So if a stock is going to announce earnings, a lot of times I'll just mark kind of where that expected move is to the upside. And if price opens above that, just like we teach in our course, then what tends to happen is price will stay above that level or go higher. In this case, we got in right here, and the same day it shot higher, and then we ended up getting out today and booked a nice profit. So I'll get to the closing trade in here in a second, but booked over 40% in just one day. So nice trade in Tesla. It played nicely with us for that trade, did what it was supposed to. Next trade was a rolling adjusting trade in IWM. So we just rolled our short call verticals. I already went over that. Just to recap, let's go back to that real quick. And this is our short call vertical. So just continuing to keep that short delta on for our portfolio, looking for a little bit of downside to benefit that piece. Next trade was an opening adjusting trade in FXI. I already went over that. We just added a butterfly. So I showed you both butterflies, both our call side and our put side. We look to close these for around 20, 25% profit. So just waiting in FXI. And then here's the closing trade in Tesla, where we booked over 40% in just one day that I just mentioned. And lastly, today we did a rolling adjusting trade in QQQ. So what we did here, which is slightly different from what we usually do on a roll, is we rolled from August to September, which is normal. But what we did here is we actually widened out the strikes a little bit. So we went from 3 strikes wide to 5 points wide, okay? And we did that to lower the cost of our roll. So we paid a smaller debit to do that roll. And then we just, you know, we continue to keep this on for that short delta in our portfolio. So if we take a look at the Qs, and the reason we did it today is just because with the up movement that we had, especially yesterday in the Qs, it kind of went out of our range. So we wanted to get back to a positive theta position. And so let's go ahead and click on that. So that's what this looks like now. So now we're in a positive theta position, as you can see right here, and just looking for some downside to benefit that piece. Now we still have our other one on in August, which is still in our range, still in a positive theta position. So that's why we have not rolled that one yet. If we can get a move next week lower, then we might either close that or roll it, depending on where our overall portfolio is in respect to a short delta position. So right now, our overall portfolio is at about 3-to-1 of our short delta to theta ratio. So remember, for every dollar of theta that we're collecting, we like to be anywhere from 1-to-1 to 5-to-1 as far as short delta, and we're right at 3-to-1, so in a good spot. And so we'll just continue to manage that as needed. So those are all the alerts from the week. Let's take a look at some of our other positions. We've got a strangle on in oil. We're up a decent amount in this trade overall, but this piece of the trade, still very centered, just looking for some more time to pass before we close that out. So if it stays in our range here and we get to about 40 to 50% of max profit, we'll close that out. But let's take a look at a chart of oil to get an idea of where implied volatility is right now. Still fairly elevated. We are at the 60 level on the IV rank, which in this case, IV rank is higher than IV percentile. Typically, you're going to see IV percentile be the higher of the two. But in this case, you can see it's IV rank based on just where the option prices have traded over time. Next trade we'll take a look at is ES/ES, which is the S&P 500 futures. We've got an iron condor on here, still pretty centered. Just waiting for some more time to pass there. And then we've also got a short call vertical, which was previously part of an iron condor. Price moved out of our range, so we closed out the untested side, just looking for a little bit of downside to get back in our range there. And then a separate trade in ES, so it's not part of our iron condor trade, but this is a long put vertical that we originally put it on just to add some short delta in our portfolio. And just still continuing to keep that on. We've rolled it several times. This is really strictly to keep some short delta in our portfolio. So looking for some downside to benefit that piece. And that's in August, which still has 14 days left. So we will potentially roll that one next week. we like to, once we get into the week of expiration, or in the next 2 weeks, I should say, once we get into the week of expiration, depending on where things are, that's when we like to roll those out. Another trade we have on is ZN, which has 49 days to expiration. This is a strangle. Spread this out a little bit so you can see it a little bit better. We are pretty centered, got some profit here. Just waiting for some more, waiting for about 40 to 50% of max profit before we book that one. I mentioned Apple, DIA, so the Dow ETF. We've got a short call vertical here, looking for some downside to benefit that piece. That's in August, and then we've also got one in September. So that one's well within our range. Could use a little bit more downside to benefit that piece. I mentioned Disney, mentioned EEM, EWW. So here's a trade that we've made a few adjustments to. This is an adjusted strangle and just looking for some downside to benefit that piece. I haven't added to this, even though price was up here, kind of, you know, near our break-even point. Typically, I would add another one, but I've been waiting for implied volatility to pop its head up a little higher, and it hasn't, and we got a contraction today. So just managing, just managing the current piece at this point, not looking to add quite yet. EWZ, we've got a strangle on here. You can see prices hanging out near the upper end of its range, but no need to adjust yet, just kind of waiting there. If we take a look at the charts, you can see we've still got fairly elevated implied volatility levels. So if we need to add to this one, if it kind of moves more towards our short strike, we may look to add another piece to this. We're just going to hold to see what happens early next week and make a decision at that point. I mentioned FXI, I mentioned Google, mentioned Goldman, mentioned IWM, NVIDIA, mentioned that one, mentioned the Qs, and then lastly, XLK. We've got this long put vertical on, just looking for some downside to benefit that. We'll be looking to roll this one or close it out next week, depending on where price is. So that's all the alerts. That's all the trades. Hope everybody has a great weekend, and we will talk to you next week. Have a good one, everybody.